These are my top 5 books for teenagers just like myself. These books have helped me learn and grow as a person and as a character, and I hope that they can do the same for you. I was dreaming of a play. It's level, it's layer, so pray for the players. We hollowed the walls. So, you want to know the 5 best books to read as a teenager. Maybe you're recommending it to a teenager, maybe you're a teenager yourself, maybe you're someone in your 20s. These books will help you figure your way out in life and broaden your perspective through reading this material. So, we're going to get into the first book out of the top 5. These are organized in no particular order, but I did put them in the order of, advanced level. So if you're someone who hasn't necessarily challenged your beliefs and hasn't really read too many books that kind of are more self-improvement and personal growth in that sort of genre, let's say you've read a lot of fantasy, then I would start off with something like this book. That's the first book, The Magic of Thinking Big. This book is what I would give to someone who thinks very small, hence the title. So someone who is very, you know, I come from a very small island, and to have the perspective of, you know, get a 9-to-5 job, be safe, don't try anything too crazy, just do your job well and go ahead and be mediocre. This kind of gives you the power of like realizing that, hey, a lot of my beliefs are my beliefs based on, you know, what my parents think or what others think of me or what I think others would think of me if I decided to go here or do that. And I think this book is good at tackling, you know, the self-limiting beliefs of I'm not good enough or I could never do that. It kind of brings into reality like you have the power within you to create amazing and big things. It's as the title says, The Magic of Thinking Big. So pretty self-explanatory. It also gives very actionable steps, success building tips. It's very basic, but very, very actionable for anyone who feels, I guess, lazy or lost in life or has an idea of what they want to do, but they just can't commit to it. I will give them this book. Next, we got The Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck. I don't know if I can even say that because it's a YouTube video, but I said it. This is a book by Mark Manson. I read this at a very weird period of my life. So I was very stressed out when I first read this book. I was in a like just stressful period of my life. And though I think there's a lot that I don't like about the book personally, I think it is really good for people who, especially teenagers or just men, women that are younger, early 20s, or are new to reading or new to self-improvement, anything of that sort. I would recommend this book because it really just teaches you the lessons of like not caring what other people think, but also being self-aware enough to realize that other people aren't thinking of you. I just think that it's a perspective that we all know, but we never have actions that I guess are congruent with that. So this book puts into perspective multiple different things. I loved the first chapter. For those of you who have read it, you know why. But yeah, it's very interesting. It's very good at just having a basic understanding of, as the title implies, not caring what other people think and really what to care about. So there's also another good chapter where it talks about picking what you're going to do. So picking what you're going to give a fuck about, caring what you're going to do. Because we have like a battery and we give a little care here and a little care there. And most of the time we give a fuck about the wrong things. So this teaches you how to give a fuck about the right things and to not care about the things that don't matter. So it's a good book for someone who, you know, is very self-conscious maybe, or someone who cares a lot about what other people think. So yeah, next I got Deep Work by Cal Newport. So this is one of those books that I will definitely find myself rereading again and again. Same thing with Magic of Thinking Big, to be honest, because these two books are just like I would say a good way to reshift or rewire your mindset. This one specifically changed my life completely from, you know, being someone whose attention span is pretty good compared to regular people, because I meditate often and I have sessions of like focused work. I don't scroll through reels all day. I've never had TikTok. I don't spend my time watching extremely short form content, which is extremely like common these days. It's short form content and doom scrolling through your phone. So this is an amazing way to understand that, you know, work isn't instant. It's results based. It's action, and how to just focus. This is the best book, I would say, to learn how to cut distractions and to focus on a deep workflow. It gives very actionable steps, and it's very simple in the sense of you don't have to be like super smart at reading or anything like that to understand the book, or you don't have to be, you know, anyone who has a complicated job. Like, let's say you like making YouTube videos like me, this will help you working towards those by focusing more and having deeper, more concentrated work and cutting out all the distractions. So very good book for anyone just wanting to work smarter and harder. The next book I would say is more targeted towards males based on the title and what's inside of the book, but I would say The Way of the Superior Man. Now, if you are a teenage woman or a younger woman, I would also recommend getting this book. I do think it's to a specific type of guy, but I think every guy should read it. And I think every teenager should read it. If you're a teenage male, anywhere from the ages of, you know, 13, 14 to, you know, even in your early 20s, late 20s, 30s, I would really give this book to really every guy I know, because it really just delves into a lot of different things about masculine energy and dancing with the feminine energy and the polarity between the two. It has like chapters that you just find yourself rereading again and again. It's definitely one of those books that I go over here and then, like, I just find myself rereading it, and I for sure am going to you know, try to put the lessons in this book into actionable steps, and I try to do that as much as I can. You can have your own opinions on the book. It's very criticized, and a lot of people disagree on the things inside. You can have whatever thought you want, but I do recommend reading it and then coming to a conclusion and a mindset of your own. But I do think for young men, this puts into perspective The Way of a Superior Man, as the title says. So, yeah. Lastly, for the fifth book, the fifth and final book, I have Man's Search for Meaning. So I read this book in high school. It was I was maybe 16, 15 last year. I was 15, yeah. And it was really just, I was also at a point when I read this where I was in a stage where I wasn't doing much. I was kind of just waking up and having like a very repetitive day. And I started to feel kind of like, you know, nihilistic, to be honest. Having just thoughts of like, why does any of this matter? And this book really just puts into perspective just the story in it. It puts into perspective everything of like the Holocaust and sweating. So I read this book in high school. I think I was like 15, and I actually read it, and one of my physics teachers was very surprised, because I think he thought I was someone that didn't know how to read, and when he saw me reading this, he was like, oh, you know how to read, and this is like an actually like good book. So that's very interesting. I honestly found it kind of complicated to read at first, mainly because I was in a period where I was reading so much self-improvement books and so much personal growth books that going from something like that to this, it's just a change. So, but I would recommend this book really to just everyone, specifically my generation, because it really just puts into perspective like how much gratitude you gotta have. And I just think this book puts everything into perspective, and it really makes you realize that, you know, from really bad circumstances, good things can come out of it. And reading a book about someone, you know, who went through concentration camps and horrific, horrific things, and such a terrible experience, just puts things into a perspective of realizing that, you know, even the hard things that you go through every day, or the hard things that maybe you went through in your childhood, good things can come out of that, and it can honestly build your character. So I think that this is an amazing book, and a must read, for especially people my age. It's not that long of a read, but I would highly recommend. So these were my five books. So those were my top five books. I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a comment down below. Subscribe and like if you enjoyed this YouTube video. I'm really trying my best to share as much knowledge as possible, and I thought that sharing the five books that have helped shape me as a teenager can hopefully help some of you out there. Let me know down in the comments if you guys recommend any books, if you guys have read any of these books, if you liked them, if you didn't like them, if you guys have maybe mixed opinions, if you've never heard of the book and you're interested in buying one, just let me know down in the links below, and I'll see you guys next time. Back of bodegas, I got plenty, it's so many, yeah, they say gimme, he got plenty, yeah.